join me on a road trip to the Elan Valley. Why am I driving to the Elan Valley in a Saab 9.5 Aero? Well, you would think because I've had so many fast Saabs on the channel, you'd think I would have done a good healthy road trip in a 9.5 Aero. Not so. The first one I bought, I didn't use it much because I had a 7 Series at the same time and I was driving the 7 Series lots. So never did anything with the blue one until the day it was time to sell it to the dude. And then the next one, Phase 1 Aero, was an estate and it was the same thing again. I think I test drove that whilst picking the kids up from school just before it was collected. And then the other two Aeros I had, the two estates, the 9.5s, both of which were espresso black, I don't feel like I ever got any to spend any time with those either. So this time, I'm doing something I've never done before. I'm gonna make a half decent video. So, road trip, Elan Valley, 2 hours. Let's see if we can do it in an hour and a half. Time that well, look at the queue now. Alpha travel. It's a bit of Geoff, isn't it?
Right, that was it. Coffee and cake, done. My review of the Elan Valley Visitor Center. Coffee could be better, cake could be better, pasty was rubbish, price was too high. This section of what is effectively the north part of Mid Wales is phenomenal. It's just rolling valleys and water everywhere you look. Although not much water at the moment. I've never seen the reservoir so low. So everybody, turn your taps off. The Saab, I have been thoroughly enjoying the Saab 9.5, although most of the day I have been stuck behind tractors and vintage motorcycles and Land Rovers herding sheep, genuinely, for miles upon mile. But when the road opens up and you plant your foot into the carpet in this car, it absolutely flies. I do think it would benefit from some decent front tyres. I think it's got proper cheap ditch finders on at the moment. With a proper set of tyres, you'd really be able to make the most of that engine, the power and the gearbox, which I haven't complained about at all. I don't mind the fact that it's an automatic. It still absolutely flies. All right then, made it to Aberystwyth on the sea. Quick dip and then turn around and drive home. You've got to go in the sea if you get to the sea, haven't you? So get my shorts on. There's an old bloke in there as well, so I'll just go join him. Let's go. You always feel good after a little swim. Get a bit of cold water on you, and everything just feels better. I mean, I felt all right today. Anyway, to be fair, but it's 100 miles home. It's saying 2 hours. Let's see if we can do it in an hour and a half. Okay, so I've done pretty much all day in the car. I've actually only covered 123 miles so far, but these are Welsh miles, so it's more like twice that. Verdict. Car's been great. Power is beautiful. It's a nice, easy car to drive. It feels quite lightweight. I don't know how Saab did that with these 9.5 petrol autos. They made them feel light in the way the engine responds. It's a lovely car to drive. If I was going to have some criticisms, I have struggled getting comfortable. The seats could do with a little bit more bolster on them. When you're driving and you're actually driving, you know, driving, you want to be held in your seat a little bit more, and the Saab just doesn't quite do that. Other than that, you know, when it's time to overtake a lorry or a tractor, absolutely, it just swallows them up. Like, that amount of usable power is just fantastic. It's been great. I mean, I've got some pixels missing on the dash. I've got some buttons that are rubbed off. But other than that, properly lovely car. I've thoroughly enjoyed my day out. Covered a few more miles now and sort of the final leg really, and I've just been driving, listening to a podcast and not thinking about filming or anything like that. And when you actually want to make progress in this car, when you want to get somewhere, it's just brilliant. And it sort of brings me on to, this is everything I love in a car. It's from the magical era of motoring when cars weren't overly complex. It's got a perfectly usable amount of power, but it's also got a split personality, unlike myself. You know, it can be just a car in a car park that looks like nothing, but when you plant your foot down at 40, 50, 60 mile an hour to overtake, to cover some ground, the acceleration is beautiful. And again, I'm reminded that all these ludicrous cars that keep coming out, these cars with all of this power and all of these capabilities, you're still driving on substandard roads. You're still driving on roads full of idiots and full of tractors and full of lorries. You don't need something that's wild all the time. You just need something that when that little bit of road opens up, when that Mercedes decides that he wants to go as well, you can go with him, even though his car's brand new. That's what I love about this car. It's maybe the 9.5 Aero, the Saab 9.5 Aero, hot turbo, maybe it is the quintessential Geoff car. Maybe this car, these cars, are everything that the whole Geoff buys cars movement is based on. They're cheap to buy, they're fast, they're comfortable, they're well built, they're respected in the car community, they're very, very cool. And they're Swedish, and they're built by a brand that were oddball. You know, Saab did do things differently, and they're not with us anymore. That's a great shame. I love it. Proper car. If you want to cover some ground at pace, then you can't go too far wrong with a Saab 9.5 Aero. Last bit now, I've got the fuel light on. I've got 42 miles left in the tank. I've covered 197 miles on 50 quid. I don't know what the fuel economy is. Let's work out the fuel economy and put it there. Let me know your thoughts on the fuel economy of this car. Right, I think that is pretty much the end of the video. I love my day. Bit of a more chilled out video from Geoff Buys Cars. Let me know what you think of that format. Would you like to see more road trips? Shall I do a road trip in every car that I have on the channel? Was it a load of rubbish? Was it boring? I guess if you made it to the end, then you wouldn't have got to the questions anyway. But that's it. Thank you very much for joining me on a trip to the Elan Valley and then to Aberystwyth. Cheers. See you for the next one. Obviously, I'm going to get changed in the car, so just don't look a minute. Close your eyes. Oh, sorry to the person that does end up with this car. My naked butt has been on the seat. True story. Right, let's go swimming. Lost my car key. I just opened the car with it. Found it. The cake was like a Geoff car. Looked a lot better in the pictures. Do you ever make videos and then watch them back and think, I hate myself? I never do that. Geoff Buys Cars. Still, YouTube's most boring car channel.